This is Susan Bradley for CSO Online. Today I'm going to talk about something that I think is a little bit overlooked, and honestly, I think it should be default in all Office 365 deployments, and that's Office 365 auditing and logging. I think it should be on by default, and it's going to be in the future, but right now you want to make sure that it's turned on and check your settings. What reminded me of this was an upcoming announcement in the Office 365 Admin Center that reminded me that Mailbox Audit is going to add mail reads by default in the coming week. This is actually something that's been asked for in the forensic investigations. It's called Mail Items Accessed Action. It offers comprehensive forensic coverage of mailbox accesses, sync operations, and will really help any kind of forensic analysis of what went on in an investigation. In early February 2019, Microsoft's going to turn this on, and initially, these logs will not be in the Unified Audit Log and will only be available from the Mailbox Audit Log. Bottom line, for those of you in Office 365, you want to take a look at this, see if you do any additional steps in order to turn on this logging. And if you're currently doing any logging, you may want to reevaluate some of the settings you've done. Now, of course, if you've never turned on auditing in the first place, one of the things I want you to do is go look at, especially in the search and investigation area of your Microsoft 365 or Office 365 console, click on the audit log search section. And if you notice up here where it says turn on auditing, if it is already enabled, then perfect, you're set to go. But here, if it says turn on auditing, then I want you to go ahead and turn on that auditing. This is an example in a sample 365 subscription that I have. And you can see even in the time that it's been on, it showcases the number of times I've logged in and which IP address I've logged in from. You can set up new alerts and actually set up alerts of actions and accesses. And again, review this section if you've not already set these things up. The second step I'll suggest that you do is check to see if you've turned on mailbox auditing. Now, to do that, you'll need PowerShell. And if you haven't connected to Exchange Online PowerShell, I'm sure you've done that by now. But just in case, there's instructions on how to do that. And once you've done connected online, then you want to enable mailbox auditing. And here you can see in PowerShell a sample of the mailbox I've turned on. I've got logging enabled for 90 days. And you can see the commands there. If you use the audit command, you can actually see if auditing is turned on in your environment. Now, I recommend enable mailbox auditing for all mailboxes in your organization. You want to set it up ahead of time, because if you come to a situation where you ask a question about access or who deleted something, and you look at your environment and you think, gee, I didn't set up the mailbox auditing, it's too late. You need to set it up ahead of time. So that's why I suggest that now, while you don't need it, you want to go ahead and enable it ahead of time, because you never know when you might need to turn on mailbox auditing and investigate what's going on. And for more information, I've got some additional resources that I've linked to in the article, including a YouTube video from Randy Franklin Smith, who's a guru on Windows security auditing, and also a white paper from the SANS InfoSec Reading Room about extracting timely sign-in data from Office 365 logs. Bottom line, I want you to take the time now to enable auditing, because you'll need it sooner versus later. Until next time, this is Susan Bradley for CSO Online.